Forced sterilizations in 2020, sadly, as American as apple pie. We know of at least 17 women in ICE custody who've had hysterectomies without their consent.
Who has removed their reproductive organs for no medical reason.
It's wrong on so many levels, but when you look back at our history, the roadmap for how we got here is very clear. We need to talk about the origins of forced sterilization, and that starts with eugenics, selective breeding to create a better race. In the early 1900s, there was fear-mongering about a genetic invasion. Many white Americans were afraid of losing their so-called purity. Demands for building a wall and anti-immigrant laws took off. Sound familiar? Some of the most elite scientists and thinkers in the country came up with a solution. Keep undesirables, basically anyone who wasn't white or physically abled, from having babies by forcibly sterilizing them.
It was sold as an uncomplicated operation that just took a few minutes. Politicians and the US public ate it up. By 1907, Indiana passed the world's first mass sterilization law. At least 30 other states quickly followed suit.
The official targets of this patchwork of eugenic laws included those labeled unfit, defective, and feeble-minded. But those were synonyms often used for immigrants and people of color. In California, the government mostly targeted Mexican women. In the South, it was Black women. At least 25% of Native American women were sterilized by the late 70s. Puerto Rico became a hotspot, with the highest sterilization rate in the world. Between 1930 and 1970, over a third of all women on the island were left unable to have children. Over 60,000 people had been forcibly sterilized in the US by the 70s, and there have been hundreds of thousands more where the consent was really questionable. It was also successful that the US started to export and sponsor forced sterilizations globally, from Peru and Guatemala to India and China. Soon, hundreds of thousands of women were robbed of their right to decide what to do with their bodies. Oh yeah, and Hitler? Well, he was so inspired by this US movement that he built the entire Nazi eugenics program in its image. Forced sterilization is now recognized as an act of genocide because it can wipe out entire ethnic groups. Okay, so we just covered a lot, and I know this is feeling pretty heavy. Let's get back to what's happening right now, to the woman sterilized in an ICE detention center. Could it be just a few rogue agents, an isolated incident? Sadly, it's not. If it's a well-documented pattern of abuse, it's systemic. This is what happens when we call people illegal. We've already seen ICE take children from their parents, sexually abuse people in their custody, let kids die in cells, repeatedly deny vital medical care, expose people to COVID. Our own staff constantly documents medical negligence and abuse from ICE. We've even sued the government over medical problems multiple times. These sterilizations show just how far ICE thinks they can push it. So now what? Reforms? Sensitivity trainings? Let them investigate themselves? You know the answer. Abolish ICE.